So now we saw this set of refactorings. They're nice, but how can we actually perform refactorings? In some cases, you'll have to do it by hand. And you'll do it in that case in small steps so that you can check at every step that you didn't introduce any error. But there's also many cases in which, at least for the more standard refactorings, you can just use a tool that actually supports refactoring. I'm going to show you how that works into a specific IDE, Eclipse, through a demo. To show you how Eclipse can help you in performing refactoring in an automated way, I just opened the Eclipse editor and I maximized it so that we can look at the code more clearly. And as you can see here, I have this class that's called Refactorable. It's a pretty indicative name. And what we're going to do, we're going to try to apply the extract method refactoring to this class. And in particular, to parts of this printOwing method. So this is a method that will print owings, as the name says. And it will do several things, such as, for example, printing a banner first, then calculating the outstanding debts, and then printing some details. So the starting point for an extract method refactoring is the identification of some cohesive code fragment. And here, for instance, we can see that if we consider these three print statements, they're basically printing some banner for the method. And I also put a comment here just to make that even more explicit. So this is a perfect case in which we might want to just extract this part, create an independent method so that we can make the code more readable and maintainable. So I select the part of the code that I want to put in my method. I invoke the contextual menu, and as you can see, there is a refactor entry here. Here, some refactorings are listed, refactorings that I can apply, and I'm going to select the extract method. When I do that, Eclipse is going to ask me to specify a method name. I'll just call this one printBanner. And as you can see, as soon as I do that, Eclipse will show me the preview or the method that will be generated. I'm going to leave the access modifier to public, and I'm not going to change anything else. So now when I click OK, as you can see, Eclipse modified my code so that now I have the printBanner method down here that does exactly what that piece of code was doing before. And I just have an invocation of a printBanner method up here where the code was before. And of course, this is something that we could have done by hand. That's pretty easy to do. But it's even easier to do it using Eclipse's capabilities. And this will become even more apparent when we consider a slightly more complex case. So here, if we look at this piece of code, for instance, we can see that this code prints some details about the owings. And the reason why this case is slightly more complicated is because this code needs to know about the value of outstanding. And whereas underscore name is a member of the class and therefore will be available to the method, outstanding is a local variable. So a method different from printOwing wouldn't know anything about outstanding. So let's see what happens when we try to apply a refactoring for this code. So we go again here to the refactor menu. We select extract method. We will pick a name again. So let's call it printDetails, since this is what the code does. And as you can see here, Eclipse was able to figure out that outstanding has to be a parameter of this method. So if you look at the signature here, this will be very clear. So outstanding has to be passed to the method because it's a local variable of the printOwing method. So it will not be visible to the other method otherwise. So since Eclipse figured it out, all I have to do is to press OK. And at this point, what I will have here is my new method, printDetails, that takes outstanding as a parameter and does exactly what the code was doing before. And here, where the code was, I will have my printDetails invocation with outstanding as a parameter. So now let's continue to extract methods and let's look at an even more complex case, which is the one involving this piece of code. So this piece of code, as you can see, will calculate the value of the outstanding debt, will calculate the owings. And the way in which it does that is by considering all the orders that are part of this enumeration that is declared here. And it will compute for each one of these orders the amount and then add it to outstanding. So what is the additional complication here? Well, the additional complication here is that this code needs to know not only about outstanding, it also needs to know about this enumeration, because this one is also a local variable. And in addition to that, this code also has some side effects. So outstanding is modified as a consequence of the execution of this code. So how can we do that in the extracted method? Well, let's see what Eclipse will do and what Eclipse will suggest if we try to again refactor this code and extract the method. In this case, as you can see, Eclipse does two things. First of all, it figures out, as before, that there are some parameters that are needed for this method to operate correctly. The enumeration E, as we said, and the outstanding variable. In addition, if you look at the method's signature, Eclipse will also figure out that this method has to return a double value. So what does this value correspond to? This value corresponds to the new value of outstanding. So if we give a name to this method, so we just use the name that I put in the comment over there, we click OK. Eclipse will create the method by extracting the code, and here, where the method used to be, we will have that the value of outstanding is updated based on the return value of calculate outstanding. So in the end, if we look at this code, you can see that if we just focus on this code, it's very easy to understand what it does. It prints the banner, it calculates some outstanding value, and then it prints some details. And in case we don't care, as I said before, about the details of what these methods do, we're done. And if we care about the details, we can look at each method individually and get exactly the same information that we got before, but in a sort of separation of concerns kind of way, by focusing on one problem at a time. So now let me do one last thing. So let me modify the code slightly. So I'm gonna go back to the version of the code before refactoring. So this is what we had, and I'm gonna add an additional variable here called count, which I initialized to zero. Here, I'm gonna increase the value of count at every iteration. And finally here, I'm gonna print out the value of count. Okay, now that I have this code, so let's imagine that I want to, again, as I did before, extract this method. So I'm gonna give you a second. Have a look at this and see if you see any problem with that. Feel free to stop the video if you need more time. So the problem here is that I have two side effects. Both outstanding and count are modified, and therefore it's not really possible to extract this method and preserve the semantics of this code. Let's see if Eclipse will be able to figure that out. And it does. If we try to extract the method here, it will tell us that there is an ambiguous return value. The selected block contains more than one assignment to local variables, and the affected variables are outstanding, which is a double, and count, which is an integer. So it will refuse to extract the method. So at this point, if we wanted to do that, we'll have to do the refactoring in a different way, but I don't really want to get there. I want to conclude here, and I hope this little demo helped you realize how useful it can be to use an IDE that supports refactoring, that can automate this important task. And I also encourage you to play with this and try to use different refactorings on your code, so as to get familiar with the kind of refactorings that are supported by the IDE, and also with the refactorings themselves and how they should be used.